holla at ya, namaste, live long and prosper, all that good stuff. Pulsehead people, how's it going? I got the memo that we were supposed to video respond really, really long after the fact because my internet has been on the fritz ever since we had a thunderstorm. How that's supposed to happen with wireless internet is beyond me, but hey, I don't ask questions, I just cry when my internet doesn't work. Anyway, so I received the mandate that I was supposed to diagram a sentence for all of you, but as all my fans, most especially Flack, will be disappointed to hear, I actually never learned how to diagram a sentence. So, sad, sad day in Whoville, guys. But anyway, I figured instead of diagramming sentences, we could go over the fundamentally important building blocks, fundamentals, basic parts of a sentence, all the same, because those are just as fun and probably important when diagramming a sentence. The first fundamental building block thing, whatever you want to call it, that is important to review and that I'm sure everyone is familiar with, is the noun, aka the person, place, or thing that you're going to put in your sentence. Now, generally, person, places, things, blah, such things aren't all that interesting on their own. Like, you could have Barack Obama. That's a person in a sentence. Not very interesting. This segues nicely into our next segment. Adjectives. That's how you make a person, place, or thing more interesting. Because they're describers. They add either the how if they go with a verb, or they just describe things. Like, you could have Barack Obama, or you could have, like, exciting Barack Obama, or flashy Barack Obama, or purple Barack Obama, or whatever you wanted. If you stick that in there, it's gonna be much more interesting. And just, instead of just saying porta potty, you could have the nasty porta potty or the smelly porta potty. Basic stuff, guys. This is easy. The other part of the sentence that you're gonna want to include, because everybody loves a good bit of action in their sentences, is a verb. Because, so help me, a nasty porta potty is not going to do anything on its own unless you give it a verb. So, you could have the nasty porta potty fell down, or the nasty porta potty exploded. People on Pulsehead seem to be really, really fond of exploded. Far be it from me to know why, I just know that it's there. Anyway, or you could switch them around. You could put the dog barked. The dog barked how? Adjective. Actually, I lied to you. This is where the adverb would come in. Something that I feel is great and neglected. Neglected. Blah, blah. I will learn how to talk. Something that I feel is greatly neglected on the site. Instead of just saying the dog barked loud, which is incorrect, you would say the dog barked loudly. Two little letters modify it and make it correct and make you sound intelligent. So yes, you could say the loud dog barked. That's correct. The dog barked loudly. Also correct. The loud dog barked loud. Wrong. Fail. Not good. Go home. Now from here we could go over things like prepositions or clauses, passive and active voice, but you know what? I think that this has given quite a few people something to think about, so I'm gonna let you go ahead. You go and practice having a person, place, or thing, modifying it with an adjective, giving it something to do with the verb, then switching them around and just going a little crazy. See what you can come up with. If this came across as condescending or really, really jerky, then congratulations. You have now discovered the wonderful device known as irony. Or sarcasm. Or whatever you want to call it. I don't really care. It's all subjective. It's however you take it. I'm just doing this video because, wow, I got stranded without a car today and I'm bored. So, yes, there you go. I follow instructions until 7:77 when I responded with a video. So, yes. Hope that somebody somewhere took something out of this and will use it for the greater good of their writing. And I was gonna say the world, but that comes across as pretty cliche. Anywho, have a lovely day, PHers. PH. Not PH bound. Have a lovely day, PHers. Live long and prosper. Bye!